Hi everyone, today we're going to create a picture of three fish under the sea. And we're going to use these wavy lines and organic shapes. So we're going to do this little 5-4-3-2-1 method. So there's five steps. Starting at the top of your paper, you're going to draw five wavy lines. That's one. This is two. And this is three wavy lines. This would be your four wavy lines. And starting at the top, going to the bottom, five wavy lines from top to bottom. Now we're gonna do five wavy lines going from side to side. That's one wavy line. That's two wavy lines, three wavy lines, four wavy lines, and the last five wavy lines. Now we're going to do four corners. So a wavy line to cut off one corner, a wavy line to cut off two corners, a wavy line to cut off three corners, and a wavy line to cut off four corners. Now we're going to make three fish. Starting in the middle of your paper, make this large teardrop. See that long teardrop in the middle of your paper? That's the body of the fish. And then just add a little tail to the end of the teardrop. And that's the shape of your fish. Each fish will have four teardrop-shaped fins. So there's two in the front and two in the back. Now we're going to make the second fish right here. And it's going to go off the page, so you're making that U shape with two fins showing, and they go off the page. And then the last fish is going to be going off the page on the bottom. And don't forget to make the tail and the teardrop-shaped fins. There's four fins. So it looks a little crazy at first. So we're going to next do the seaweed. We're going to do two seaweeds on the side. Each side gets two. So we're just going to make this shape here. It's like a spike, two little spikes. And then we're going to outline with the black. So whatever black you might have, I'm going to use a black crayon. Outline the fish first so we don't get all confused. Remember, the fish is just this big teardrop shape and the fins. So first there's your teardrop shape for the fish's body, and then you have the four fins on the sides. One, two, three, four. So there's four teardrop shaped fins on the side of the body. Now notice that I'm also going to add whatever lines that might be cutting through your fish's body. I want you to outline those lines. And that is the design inside your fish. It's not all going to look the same because your lines might have been different than mine. So we're going to outline the last fish. Remember, this is the tail. It's like a long little tube. And then these four teardrop shaped fins on the side of your fish's body. And don't forget, whatever designs might be inside your fish's body, outline those too. So there's your outline. Now don't get confused. These are the four fins. See that? One, two, three, four. And one, two is showing on the top because it's going right off the page there. So we're going to use red, orange, and yellow crayon for the fish, and we're going to alternate those colors. So when I say alternate, that means that you find the shape inside of your fish and color it red, and then when you see another shape, alternate. Use a different color that's not red. So we're going to use orange. And since we're only using red, orange, and yellow, I'm going to keep switching between red, orange, and yellow in a pattern. So if I do yellow here, I don't want the next shape to be yellow. I'm going to change it to either orange or red. We don't want the same colors to be touching. So we're going to change it up. Red, orange, yellow, red, orange, yellow in a pattern of your choosing. So the whole fish is going to be this warm color right here. Red, orange, yellow. Red, orange, and yellow. There we go. We're going to do the same thing on each fish. So take your time with your crayons and color in, alternating or changing the colors as the shapes change. So here we are. I have my red, and then I'm going to change to yellow. Now I'm going to change to orange. I'm going to do this big space in the middle here, orange. And sometimes I like to go around the shape with the color that I'm trying to color it. So I go around the shape first, and that way it's a little bit easier to stay inside the lines when I color the whole shape. So this whole thing, I'm just going to do it all orange. Filling it in, making sure it's nice and solid there. There we go. And then I'm going to switch to either red or yellow and do the next shape. And notice I'm coloring around that shape and then filling it in with the red. Now I'm going to switch to yellow. Yellow will be the next shape here. Filling it in. And the next, maybe I'll do all the yellows at once. Make sure the yellows aren't touching. And then switch to your orange. You're alternating. And then switch to your reds. So that we have the whole fish colored in this warm color variation. So I have now just a few more shapes to fill in, and I'm gonna fill it in with the orange. There we go. So there we have it. See that? Red, orange, yellow, red, orange, yellow, red, orange, yellow. One more fish to go, and it's at the bottom here. And I'm gonna start to alternate my colors, going from orange to red and then to yellow. Orange to red to yellow as the shape changes. So make sure you try your best to stay inside the lines of your fish. And if you wanna do all the yellows at once, you can. We just want to make sure the same color is not right side by side with the same color. We want to alternate. We want to change colors. So orange would change to yellow, and then yellow would change to red. And make sure you fill in the whole fish with your orange, yellow, and red. We're almost there. Just have a few more things to do to the fins. Make sure your fish has four fins, two on the back, two in the front. Just that simple tear shape, teardrop shape. Okay, and there we have it. Our warm colors are on the fish shapes. Now we're gonna do the two seaweeds. Remember that zigzag line we did? So we're just gonna zigzag outline with the black. There we go. It's just a up to a point, down, up to a point, and down again, zigzag. And then make sure you outline whatever designs might be inside that seaweed shape. Okay, and it'll be different on yours. It's not gonna be the same as mine. So now we're gonna switch to green, and each section is going to be either green or lime green. So we're gonna skip over, we're gonna do green, and then we're gonna skip over a space and then do green. So that way we could do lime green in between. So I have my darker green first. Now I'm going to take yellow to get that lime green color. Color yellow first, and then take your green right over on top of the yellow. and you'll see it changes to lime green. And there we have our seaweed with green and lime green. So first I'll take a shape from the seaweed, color it in a solid green, and then I'll take my yellow, color in the next shape with yellow, but I want it to be lime green, so what do I have to do? Take the green and go over the yellow, and that creates that nice lime green, or a lighter green. There you go. All right. Now, you're going to outline all the rest of your lines with black. So go ahead and outline all the rest of your lines, and that's all the space between your fish and seaweed. And this is all going to be the space for purple and blue. We're going to do alternating purple and blue in all of these shapes. You're going to go purple, blue, and we're going to use paint for that. We're going to switch to paint. So from crayons to paint, here we go.
The human world, it's a mess. Life under the sea is better than anything they got up there. The seaweed is always greener in somebody else's lake. You dream about going up there, but that is a big mistake. Just look at the world around you, right here on the ocean floor. Such wonderful things around you. What more are you looking for? Under the sea, under the sea. Darling, it's better down where it's wetter. Take it from me. Up on the shore, they work all day. Out in the sun, they slave away. While we've been boating full time, you're floating under the sea.
I'm just putting purple and blue, and I'm alternating purple and then blue, and then purple and then blue. Keep it going, guys.
We want the land folks loves to cook. Under the sea we have to hook up. We got no troubles. Life is the bubbles under the sea.
Under the sea.
Under the sea.
Under the sea.
Since life is sweet here, we got to be here
naturally.
Even the sturgeon and the ray, the earth is got to play. We got the spirit, you got to hear it under the sea. Play the flute, the cop, play the hop, the place, play the bass, and the sound, the chop, the bass, play the brass, the chop, play the top. The flute is the duke of soul. The way he can play the legs on the strings, the chop, rocking on the blackfish, he sings his belt and his front, they know where it's at, they know that blowfish blow.
Filled in with your blue and your purple, but make sure you're taking your time and you are using a lot of water in your watercolor. The water will activate that watercolor paint. keep it going until you have all the shapes filled with your blue and your purple. Paper sometimes, so that way your hand or your arm doesn't get paint on it. So if you have to adjust your paper, go ahead and turn your paper so that way you can paint freely without getting your hand or your arm in the paint. Keep going! You have a little bit left to go. Blue and then purple, and then blue and then purple, and then blue and then purple. Go, go, go! Even the sturgeon and the ray, the earth is got to play. We got the spirit, you got to hear it under the sea. The mute play, the flute, the cop play, the hop, the plays play, the bass and the sound, the chop, the bass play, the brass, the chop play, the tub, the flute is the duke of soul. The way he can play, the lings on the strings, the chop, rocking on the blackfish, he sings his belt and his front, they know where it's at, they know that blowfish blow. Left and you're done. Make sure that you post your artwork on Google Classroom so I can see it. Thank you so much, guys. I can't wait to see your stuff. There it is.